we're gonna actually go like that with these two fingers. So that's how far we're gonna plant them apart. So you put them down one finger, that's where one seed's gonna go, and then you're gonna put another seed there. And then you move your hand over, put another seed there.
At a former East Austin brickmaking factory, the Sustainable Food Center is reviving soil and neighborhood solidarity through sustainable gardening methods.
The Sustainable Food Center's mission is to cultivate a healthy community by strengthening the local food system and improving access to nutritious, affordable food. What we're all about is making sure that people in Austin, no matter what part of town they live in, have access to good food. We view that as a human right, not a privilege.
600 community volunteers helped break new ground in 2012 on land donated by the Meredith family. Long-term vision includes a vital community park.
Our teaching garden was originally conceived as a place where we could teach folks about sustainable, water-efficient planting techniques. We have all of our classes out here, all of our gardening classes for adults. We host school field trips. It's open to the public at any time. They can wander through. We have signs that kind of explain what's going on in the garden.
It's been a backbreaking process. Along with ridding Bermuda grass, they excavated lots of debris.
This site used to be a brick factory back in the day, and so we have no soil. We are pure sand and cinder, which has been really frustrating to work with, and so a lot of our soil is imported.
The teaching garden illustrates options to suit anyone's good taste. For space-challenged folks, square-foot gardens pack a big edible punch. They break up the grow-in-a-row notion with stylish horseshoe beds.
And then we also have a lot of pollinator plants. We want to get our native pollinators out there, bees and butterflies and hummingbirds, making sure that they're pollinating all of our fruits and vegetables as well. Part of our garden then is the demonstration side, water conservation being an emphasis for us since we're in Central Texas. We have a keyhole compost bed as well, which is just another raised bed kind of in a circular shape. And there's a compost right in the middle of it. And so we fill that with all of our scraps and plant scraps, and that slowly seeps back into the soil, into the bed, and adds nutrients to that. We showcase those ollas, the big clay pots that slowly seep water into the ground. So you reduce overhead watering, which can just lead to evaporation. And then we also have drip irrigation throughout the whole garden. We have a wicking bed that has a reservoir of pebbles at the bottom and then soil on top of that. And you fill again from below, and the water slowly wicks up into the soil and helps those roots grow nice and strong down towards that water source.
To capture rainwater and keep it on site, they designed the Quonset hut to channel it into barrels and sunken rain gardens. They selected plants that can take drought to flood swings.
When the rain comes off the roof, it fills it up, it looks flooded, you're kind of worried for the little plants underneath, are they going to drown? But then it percolates down and everybody's fine and they're watered.
Some of the harvest heads to the Sustainable Food Center's Happy Kitchen, where families learn to cook with fresh ingredients. The rest goes to local food banks, volunteers, and the kids that plant and harvest their gardens.
I want a strawberry. I want to get those strawberries.
Look at those beautiful red strawberries.
In a partnership with Creative Actions After School program, children come every Friday to dig in.
But the majority of kids that come out here really have not seen plants or vegetables or fruit being grown in the ground. And they really kind of gain a new perspective when they see, you know, a fresh carrot being pulled out of the soil, or see a tomato on the actual plant and can pick that themselves. And a lot of the times they, when they're able to plant that, they have ownership then over that plant, and they're much more likely to then eat that fruit or vegetable that they might not have eaten if they had just seen it, you know, at the cafeteria or something like that.
Oh!
See, I told you. The strawberries are
gone. Here we go, little
mama. I'm watering you with my hand.
The strawberries are gone.
Yeah, can I
drink
water?
That's so cool.
Yeah.
And they learn a lot about gardening, so they're planting and harvesting and tending for their garden. But they also have kind of a creative twist to things. During our grand opening, we had a lot of folks out here kind of celebrating the garden, and we asked everyone to write down their name or a memory or a wish they gave to our garden and write that on a really pretty ribbon that we hung in our arborway. And it keeps birds away, which is the first kind of purpose of it, but it's also just really pretty, kind of adds a touch of color to the garden. Children love it. Children always are playing in it.
The new space includes community gardens sponsored by the St. David's Foundation. Who knows how good health starts with good food?
The whole idea is that it's a space that is shared by a bunch of individuals who live nearby. They're able to cultivate a little patch of land and also contribute to the maintenance of the whole area.
The Sustainable Food Center cleared brush, leveled ground, and installed water. They provide ongoing education to gardeners who put their stamp on homegrown food. The community garden's compost pile gets an extra boost from the compost peddlers.
When people are connected to the earth, when they're connected to nature, we're inherently more happy, we're inherently more healthy. And by having families do this together, that's not only strengthening kind of the family ties within one family, but then the community as well. And we really do hope that this space educates adults and children alike, and that it brings them together and creates those kind of familiar ties and bonds and that sort of thing, relationships with other community members. And that's what the space is. It's really just a place for the community to get to know each other and to become more comfortable in nature.